Hi everyone, Grace here, and today I'm going to be giving you a brief overview of the entire functionality of CoWriter. So first things first, we do have to turn CoWriter on, and to do that we're going to come to the CoWriter icon on our browser, give a click and it'll open up a menu, and all you have to do is slide that bar over above the first option and you'll have it on. You can tell it's on because the word prediction box will appear. And I would say word prediction is probably the most iconic function of CoWriter, and I'm going to show you how to use it right now. There's a couple different ways. I'm going to start typing first, and you can see that as I type, the words are going to change, and the system will basically try to predict what I'm going to say. I'm going to start writing, "My name is Grace," so I'll show you.
My.
So after each word that you type, when you hit that space button, it's going to read that word back just to make sure that that's what you meant. And as you can see here, I started typing name, and I'm going to go into the options a little bit. So CoWriter is optimized to give you both correct grammar, and we have what's called flexible spelling. And that basically means that if you spelt something close to right, couple letters off, something like that, or you switch the first two letters around, the first and the last letter around, CoWriter is going to look at that and say, oh, I think this person might mean this word. And it's going to predict it in one of the five predictions that it will give you. So I started writing name, but I just wrote N-A. And number four right here,
man,
says man. So maybe I was trying to type man, but I put an N instead of an M. Common mistake, but CoWriter, since it has that flexible spelling, is going to be predicting things like that, which is really helpful if you're a more creative speller like myself. Otherwise, though, it is also optimized for grammar correctness. So you can see it's giving me the suggestion of name is, because that would be a correct situation with the words that I've used so far. It wouldn't be my name are, it would be my name is, so it's predicting correct grammar in the singular to go along with the grammar of my sentence. And I'm actually meaning to do that, so I am going to select the number two choice, my name is. But there's a couple ways that you can select words that CoWriter has predicted for you. So the first is to just see it and then continue typing on your keyboard. But the other way is to click or use your numeric keys. So you hover over the words and they will read out to you, so you will know what the different words are. So
name is.
I hover over name is. Yeah, that sounds right. That's what I want. So I can give a click.
Name is.
On the word, and it will put it into my sentence. Otherwise, if you don't want to click on the word, you can use your numeric keys on your keyboard. If I wanted to use the word not, that coincides with the number two. So I click the number two on my keyboard.
Not.
And it's going to put not in there. If you want to put numbers into your sentence, since if you just typed a number with the word prediction up, it would put in a word if you use the number one through five. To put numbers in, all you do is click on the numbers at the bottom right corner. And it'll come up with the numbers, and then you can either use the numeric keys or you can click and it'll put those numbers in there. So that's really easy. Another way, though, if you don't want to be typing, if you can't type, if you just your fingers are tired, you can use our speech to text. And that's a really cool option. I like to use this all the time. If I'm typing something lengthy, I can just talk and CoWriter will type for me. So you want to come to this microphone down here in the bottom right. And it comes up with this window. And basically, when I click there, I'm going to be able to speak. And CoWriter will listen to me and type out what I want to say. So I'm going to say, my name is Grace. My name is Grace. So to turn it on, you click the big microphone. It'll turn blue. To turn it off, you click the microphone again, and it'll turn back to white. I'm going to put a period and let CoWriter read that for me.
My name is Grace.
So as you can see, that works really well. Also, if you're wanting to do not typing or just speaking, and then it will read back to you as well, just like regular CoWriter. So come back to the pencil if you want to go back to your word prediction. Another great functionality that we have on CoWriter is topic dictionaries. And that basically means that if you want to type about a certain topic, or if you're writing about a specific thing for school, CoWriter will help you do that by suggesting vocabulary, grammar, names, words, places, things like that, that go with a specific topic that you enter in. So to get to that function, you come to the book right here in the middle.
Chicken.
And these are all of your topics. These are just ones that I've used recently, ones that are in CoWriter. And so if I want to turn that on, if I want to talk about ballet, I can turn this on here. And then I go back to my typing. And then I can start typing about ballet.
When, capital I.
So when I started typing, it has suggested dance, danced, dance in French. So you can see it's starting to predict words that have to do with ballet and dance. So when I dance. And just by typing BA, it's going to start doing ballet, ballets, stuff like that. So that is also a really great way that you can talk about certain topics. But let's say you want to find one that's not on here. I want to talk about football. I can search football. And basically, there are two different kinds of dictionaries that CoWriter will have. The first are saved dictionaries, and those are preloaded. They come with CoWriter. That's how they are. And those are going to be indicated by this little ribbon right here. So all these up until that line are dictionaries that CoWriter already has. But let's say I want to learn about, I don't know, the Bill of Rights. There aren't any topic dictionaries with that ribbon. All we have is ones with this little globe. And that little globe basically means that these are topics that are going to be web scraped. So CoWriter is going to go out into the internet, scrape together vocabulary, people, places, all those good things, and create a topic dictionary for you to use based on what you've searched. And so even if CoWriter doesn't have what you want to write about, you can create a topic dictionary and still write about it using the different functionalities of CoWriter with the spelling, grammar, word prediction, all that good stuff. So I'm going to select Bill of Rights.
Bill of Rights.
And it'll take a second to load while it's creating my topic. Oh, it's been created. I'm going to turn the ballet topic off and now go back to typing. And now when I start writing, I'm going to say, I don't know, freedom. That's giving me
freedom.
Let's see, I'm freedom. Also going to type Bill of Rights.
Bill.
So as soon as I space out of Bill and I start typing of, it automatically suggests of and rights because of that topic dictionary that I have turned on.
Of rights.
So I'm going to turn that off now. And the last thing that I'm going to show you is how you can use CoWriter in a different language. And this is actually really cool, and a lot of this technology is pretty new. So I'm going to show you, first of all, how you can change your word prediction into a different language if you are learning a different language, or if you want to use your native language, if it's not English, or just practice a new language. If you want to come here, you can go to the Options menu. And this Options menu is also going to have places that you can personalize your CoWriter, so text color, background color for your word prediction box, number of guesses, the font size, has all of your topics here, as well as who's speaking. You can select which voice you want, if it speaks individual letters, or the words after you space, which I do have on, speak sentences when you add punctuation, as well as the volume, speed, and pitch of the voice that you're listening to. So all of this side right here is personalization that you can really make CoWriter your own and really see what you want to see while you're writing. But over here we have more of the nitty gritty, and I'm going to turn on my prediction language, which is right here. It's on English right now, but I'm going to do French. So it's downloading the resources. It's really getting my French in there. We're actually taking a translation source from outside of CoWriter and bringing it in, downloading it in. So it will take about 20 to 30 seconds to load up. But I also speak French as well as English. So that's why I chose French. I'm going to come out of my window. And then you will have to turn CoWriter back on. But as you can see, it's now all in French. So I can start typing. And it's, again, optimized for correct spelling, correct grammar, all that stuff. So I can just right,
je
Je
Accent grave.
And je m'appelle as my name is, so I can finish with Grace.
Je m'appelle Grace.
So same sentence I typed before, just in French. So that's really easy, as well as if you want to now speak in French, and then it will type in French. So I'm going to show you that as well. It's the same exact thing in English, but if you wanted to speak, but in a different language, and then it will type in a different language, which is pretty cool as well. So I'm going to come back up here now, back to my options menu. I'm going to put this back on English. It's going to reload again, and it will take a couple more moments just to get your stuff back over to English, remove that outside translation. But that's a really cool thing that we do have, and that's really going to help with scaffolding or people who English is a second language or who just want to write in their native language or a different language that they're learning. Really cool, really great. Now, the last thing I'm going to show you is this bottom part right here, the translate writing into English. Right now it's off. I'm going to turn it on. Now I'm going to go to French. Obviously, you can see we have a ton of different languages. I'm going to select French right here. It should be loaded up there. I'm going to come back out. And then you will have to turn co-writer back on again when you change it. Anytime you change the language, since you're bringing in an outside translation source, you're going to have to return on co-writer. That's all good. So now you can see my word prediction looks a little bit different. I have my five options, but then I have the language symbol here, as well as a number six option that says French to English abbreviated right here. And so if I'm going to start typing and I can't think of an English word, but I can think of it in French, co-writer is going to then predict that word for me in English. So I'll show you. I'm going to say the butterfly flies. So I'm going to type V. And then I can't think of the word for butterfly in English, but I can think of it in French. So I'm going to start typing it in French. But type it out in French, and it gives me some suggestions of possible English words that are similar with papillon, but I mean butterfly. So this bottom one down here says butterfly, and I can hover my cursor over it.
Butterfly.
Yeah, butterfly, that sounds right. And so I can select it.
Butterfly.
And it will then change what I would like my word to be into English. So that's really cool.
The butterfly flies.
And it will, like I said earlier, help with the scaffolding and really with learning language, learning vocabulary, and being able to interchange those words like that is really going to help new words in a different language stick in students' minds as they learn. Now, the last thing I'm going to show you is our speech-to-text with the other language with the translate feature on. Same place as before. So this is just the English, but when you have that translate feature on, you can come over to French and English, and you can give any kind of speech in French, and it's going to translate it and then type it for you in English. So I'm going to say my name is Grace in French, like I typed up there, and it will translate it for me into English. So I will show you. Je m'appelle Grace.
My name is Grace.
So as you can see, it's all translated into English for me, even though I spoke in a different language. And we have a ton of different languages on co-writer, so chances are your native language or a language that you're trying to learn is supported. So this would be a great way for you to become fluent, not only in reading and speaking, but also in writing using this language feature on co-writer. So that is all. Obviously, very brief overview. There's a lot of other functionality that can be explored. If you have any more in-depth questions, you can visit our website. And there will be more videos kind of breaking down some of the different tools that I did the overview of. So you can look into those a little bit deeper and see a couple more different functions. But this is just the basics of co-writer. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed. Again, if you have any questions, visit our website. Otherwise, enjoy using co-writer.